It's a lizard who's had a little swim. He's swam across from where the buffalo are, and he's now taking it quite easy on the shallows there. Let's see if he carries on. You'll see how amazing it is when they move through water. I think it's a bit shallow now. He's almost waddling and wading through the water, but you see that long tail that comes up every now and then. That's going to help propel this animal through the water, and they can actually swim incredibly fast. So really nice to see our monitor lizard swimming. It's also quite a warm afternoon, so I'd imagine it spent a lot of time in the sun getting warm and getting that body temperature up, which will mean that it'll be quite active, and now it can just go and look around for food, and it will be hunting in the shallows here. It will look for insects, frogs, and eggs that it can find. Sometimes they'll go after things like the lapwing eggs that were around here. Now, I'm not sure what happened to those lapwing eggs. I heard something about a naughty elephant that may have potentially squashed those eggs, but hopefully that wasn't the case and they just hatched and they got out the way. But I fear the worst for them. But if they hadn't, this guy would have been on the prowl trying to find those lapwing eggs. And now the thing is when they do go near a lapwing egg, you'll find the lapwings are very, very clever. They'll be able to push and come, and they pretend like they've got broken wings, and they'll cry and make a lot of noise, and the monitor lizard then looks at them and gets distracted, and so the lapwing will slowly move away from the eggs and pull that monitor lizard away and protect the eggs. It really is quite phenomenal to watch that interspecies relationship between monitors and lapwings, as well as monitors and crocodiles. If there was a crocodile here with eggs, you'd find that monitor lizard would be getting chased all over the place by a crocodile to keep it away. And look how it's using its tongue. You see how it goes over the mud. It uses that tongue to taste what's going on. So it's effectively the way that a lot of the animals out here, like the mammals, will smell and will try and use their sense of smell to figure out what's going on. The monitor lizard is exactly the same. It uses its tongue to taste what's going on and to try and find what is here hidden in the mud, and if there is anything that they can potentially grab. Now, Jenny Animation, you say it's a water dragon. They do look a bit dragon-y, don't they, as they slither through the water. I suppose this is where Loch Ness Monster came from, is something like this. I would imagine that a big monitor lizard would look quite scary on a bit of film. Now, it seems as though as we're sitting here, just more and more animals are arriving. As our monitor lizard negotiates his muddy terrain,